Hey people in America and all over the world, Paul Mucker here again. Today's June 15th, 2011 at 9:13 p.m. Eastern Time. People, what did I tell you all? Didn't I say we're gonna have another super full moon in June, by June 15th, June 14th, 15th? Did I call it right, my people? Okay. Did I call it right or what? It's ripe. Okay? It is ripe. Look at that, people. It is beautiful. Hey. Hey, Yaya. You're back, huh? I told him you was coming, my lord. I told him you was coming back. I call it, my lord. Anyway, people, I'm going to use this opportunity, right, to give you all some news, right? Those of you who have been following me, right, you all know for the past couple of weeks I've been saying that Obama, how come that every time there's a super full moon, Obama leaves the country? So people, as y'all can remember, right, check the facts. The first super full moon was March 19th. Where was Obama March 19th? In Brazil and South America, right? And what did he visit? He visited the ancient sites. Okay? Look at the facts. Then on April 15, 14, 15, 16, around there, we had another super full moon. And where was Obama at? Obama went to California. People, I checked the facts, right? And April 14th, right, 2011, right? Obama got summoned to California, to Area 51, right? I'm gonna show you all the facts later. Obama got summoned to Area 51. Why? Because there was some abnormality going on. Hold up, I'm trying to fix it. There's some abnormality going on in that area. Anyway, on April 14th, a UFO came from that area and sped towards Washington, D.C. And it was intercepted by the Air Force. Okay? So, Obama was summoned to California because of those abnormalities. Or anomalies, whatever you want to call it. Anyway, so Obama went there. And the UFO was intercepted going to Washington, D.C. Obama stayed at Washington, D.C. when the super full moon was there. That was April. In May, between May 21 to May 24th, we had a super full moon again. Where was Obama at? Obama was in Europe. What was he visiting? The ancient sites in Ireland and England, okay? Obama ran to England and he was doing his voodoo with the Pope and with Queen Elizabeth. As I showed you all in the song, Welcome to the Hotel California. And as my friend Colin, I think, I can't remember his name, but he made a video showing us. No, his name is Mr. Forgive my friend, I can't call your name right now, but anyway, he showed us a video where Obama is signing the date. Instead of signing May 24, 2011, he signed May 24, 2008. And when I checked the facts out, on May 24, 2008, a tornado struck Oklahoma. On May 24, 2011, a tornado struck Oklahoma. So these people are either messing with time, people. People, if you believe in a God, if you believe in powers, then you know these people could mess with time, okay? They cannot stop it, but they could mess with it, okay? They could do something, people, okay? They could do something, and they are doing something, okay? They are messing, they are messing with the earth. And they're messing with the sun and the moon, okay? They're messing with it. And Hold on, people. Give me a second. My stand is moving. Okay. See, I'm up on my roof, and it's kind of, I have it on a tripod, and it keeps sliding. Okay, anyway, like I was saying, right, I lost my train of thought. Anyway, people, Obama, my friend showed us Obama signing the wrong dates. And if you check facts, the same thing that happened on May 24, 2011 in Oklahoma, the same thing happened on May 24, 2008 in Oklahoma. So anyway, I got suspicious, right? Because when I made that video, Hotel California, it said that Obama will visit Puerto Rico. So my mom was visiting Puerto Rico at the same time. So I'm saying, why is Obama visiting Puerto Rico at the same time my mother is visiting Puerto Rico? So I sent Obama a message. I told him he better leave my mother alone, because I used to live in Puerto Rico too. And when I was in Puerto Rico as a kid, a lot of stuff was, strange stuff was going on. Okay, people, strange stuff was going on with me in Puerto Rico. So they tried, something tried to dig out my eyes. When I was a kid, when I was in Puerto Rico, something tried to dig out my eye, my right eye, several times. So it was like something supernatural. So I don't know what's going on, but anyway, I said to my friends, I said, look, we're going to have a super full moon in June, and let's see if Obama going to leave the state again. And people, true enough, we have a super full moon. It came on the 13th, and where's Obama? In Puerto Rico. Obama went to Puerto Rico on June 13th, he was in Puerto Rico. Okay? People of America and all over the world, Barack Obama is scared of the super moon. People of America and all over the world, the super moon is hunting Barack Obama. Okay. People of America and all over the world, Barack Obama is afraid of the super moon. Something is hunting him. Something is hunting him. So that tells us that he have something to do with the devil. Why is he running? Obama, the Rothschild and the Pope, the Trinity. I believe Obama is Amen. Okay, people. A lot of people think that Amen was a good Egyptian god, but Amen was not. Amen was a usurper, okay? Amen is a usurper. Okay. So, anyone want to believe that Amen is a good person? He's not. Amen was the one who overthrew the sun. Okay? When the Egyptians used to worship Ra as the sun, Amen, he was a pharaoh. Amen overthrew Ra as the sun and say that the man is God, okay? So y'all better know your facts before y'all go and think that Amen is a god. Amen was a man. Amen was an Egyptian man, an Egyptian pharaoh, who decided that the sun shouldn't be God. And that's why he put his name Amen Ra. He said that he should be first and the sun is second. And Peter the creator should be like Amen, Amen, Amen Ra Peter. Okay? He's the one who came with the Holy Trinity stuff. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. And he put himself as first. Okay? He's a usurper. When Herod is really the true heir. It's not Amen, it's Herod. Amen and Jesus Christ is the same person. Jesus Christ and the Messiah is not the same person. Read it in Isaiah 7 and Isaiah 8. Two of them were born, people. Two of them. One was called Emmanuel. And one was called Maher Shabbos. What is it? It's in, I think it's in Isaiah chapter 8 or Isaiah chapter 7. Two sons were born. Two of them. Okay? It's spelled M-A-H-E-R S-H-A-L-L-A-L, I think. Baz. And the other one name was Emmanuel. So there were two of them born, the Christ and the Antichrist. Okay? I think it's Paul McLean Obama, people. Honestly, I think Paul McLean Obama. Because how come I'm the one who calling on the moon and he keep running from the moon? Okay? Because God will never, the Almighty would never pit a white man against a black man. And he would never pit a black man against a white man. He would never pit a Chinese man against a white man or a black man. Okay? He would never pit a Jew. Yeah, the Almighty, he will never pit a Jew against a black man. So the Christ and the Antichrist cannot be of two different races. They'll have to be the same race with mixture. See, Obama is mixed, okay? He's mixed black and white, okay? And that's where the problem came in, okay? Isaac and Ishmael, okay? Isaac was a usurper. Isaac is really Amen. See, they just change the names around and change the stories around, but Isaac in the Bible is Amen, okay? Ishmael is the true heir. Ishmael is the Egyptian. That's the true heir. And Isaac usurped the throne because Ishmael was the oldest. Okay, and he was an Egyptian, not an Arab, an Egyptian. Okay, they just stole Egyptian legacy and heritage. Okay, Isaac, Isaac was the son of Osiris and Sarah. Sarah is really Sekhmet, Venus. Okay, Sarah is really Venus. So our moon Osiris had Isaac, which is really the Antichrist, with Sarah, and Seth, which is Abraham, got mad and killed his brother Amalek. Because if you remember, people, read the story when Abraham said that Sarah was his sister wife, right? And he set up the Egyptian king. He set up Osiris. He pretended that he was his sister wife, and then when Osiris went and had sex with her, he demanded that he get land and livestock, okay? And then he killed Amalek, which is Osiris. People read the story good, okay? The story of Sarah, Abraham, and the kings, the Egyptians, and Isaac, same story. It's the story of Osiris and Seth. Osiris, Seth, Sekhmet, and Isis. Isis was the bonds made. Isis, Earth, that's the bonds made. And Sarah is Venus. It's not people, okay? It's not people. These people are talking about planets and the heavenly bodies. Okay, it's not people. So the story of Abraham and Sarah and Isaac is the same story of Osiris, Isis, Heru, and the child that they had with Sekhmet, which is Ampu, okay? Because if you remember, right, in the story where Isaac had twin sons, Isaac and Esau, one of them came out red and hairy. That was Ampo the dog. Okay? People, have you all seen the Bush baked bean video with the Bush dog? He said he's gonna tell the secret. That's the dog. The secret, people, you know what the secret was? When Seth killed Osiris, right? And Sekhmet and Sekhmet and Isis buried his body. Ampu is a dog. Ampu is the only one who knows where dead bodies are buried. Okay, so Ampu told Seth where Osiris was buried in return for what? For a bowl of stew. Okay. Ampu was hungry, and he's a hunter, and he came home and Jacob was cooking a stew. So they just switch up the story. Anyway, the story is that Ampu, the Egyptian dog Ampu, they didn't revere him because he was good. They revere him because they were afraid of him, because dogs can smell dead bodies. And when Isis and Sekhmet buried Osiris, Ampu was the one who showed Seth where the body was buried. And so Seth, he dug it up for Seth, and Seth gave him the intestine. And so Seth cut up Osiris' body into 13 pieces and scattered them. Okay? So Ampu was the traitor. So what the Egyptians did, they started burying the bodies deep within the earth. They wouldn't bury them. They wouldn't hide in the bodies from grave robbers, people. They would hide in the bodies from dogs, from jackals, okay? They would hide in the dogs from jackals. I mean, the bodies. They were hiding the bodies from jackals. And what they did, they cut out the hearts and the vital organs and put them in jars. Because so the dogs wouldn't get them. So, what they say, if you were a bad person and the dog got you, that means if the dog get your body, that means you're evil. Okay? So, if the dog get your body, you're evil. So, if the dog didn't get your body, then you'll pass on to the new life. So, that's why these people worship dogs, because they were scared of the dogs. That they think that the dog had some kind of power, because their nose was so powerful that they could find dead bodies no matter how deep it's buried. And the Egyptians saw that as something divine. How the hell can you worship a dog? Okay? They believe that the dog determined whether they should pass to the afterlife or not. And so Abraham came down and turned dog into God. Because it's a God. Because if you think that a dog have your life, have your life, your eternity in this hand, a dog could determine whether you go to heaven or not, you gotta be sick in your head. Okay? So the Egyptians believed that. And so did the Romans and everybody else. Everybody believed that, and that's why they call him, and they turned him from dog to God. Dogma. I'm God. Okay? Because people, Egyptian, read from right to left. The Egyptian read and read from right to left. The Hebrew and the Romans read from left to right. So if the Egyptians spell dog, the Romans and the Jews gonna interpret it as God. If the Egyptian put dogma, the Jews and the Romans are gonna interpret it as I'm God. So that's where the concept came from, people. They're tricking you all with words. Okay, there's no God. He's a dog. A dog that determines whether you're gonna pass onto the afterlife or not, which is bullshit. Okay? So that's why they call Sirius the dog star, because our souls are reincarnated by Sirius. Okay? So this is Sirius as the dog star. That's the star that determines whether they should pass onto the afterlife or not. People, the Christianity is based on foolishness. They reversed the Egyptian belief. Reversed it. The Egyptian didn't worship this stuff as God. They did not. The Egyptians didn't worship dogs as God. They had the dogs to show that dogs are going to get you. They had the dogs as an example of what not to be like. Dogs are gluttonous. Dogs are disgusting. Dogs will eat their own doo-doo. You'll pet a dog and you feed a dog, and that will still steal from you. You could take care of a dog, people. People, I don't care. A lot of you love dogs and think that dogs are better than people. Some of them are, but I'm telling something right now, right? Because people and dogs think alike sometimes. You feed a dog, and you put down your choicest piece of chicken down, and you put it down, and you go, what's gonna happen? The dog gonna eat it. Okay? No matter how full it is, it's gonna eat your food anyway. That's gluttony. A dog would throw up just to make room to put more food in his stomach. That's gluttony. You could pet a dog and feed it. The dog would turn around and snap at you or bite you. That's treachery. If you have a dog to guard you, oh, you did you see that flash around the moon? Where is it? Oh, it's a plane, I think. Yeah, it's a plane. If you have a guard dog and someone come and pet that dog, okay, that dog will allow that person to come in your house and get you. Okay, dogs love to be pet and powdered and pampered. Yes, they are loyal to a point. Okay, but dog will turn on you in a heartbeat. Just like a Rothschild, you could take care of a dog, that dog will shit in your house no matter what. Just like a Rothschild will do. like I was saying, just like a Rothschild would do. You take care of them, you invite them in your home, just like the Egyptian did. Invite the Rothschild in their home, and what they did, they shit on the Egyptians. Shit on them. You fed them and they shit on you. Okay? So the Egyptians used a dog as an example of what not to be like. That's what it was. What is it? I think it's called Sebek, the crocodile and that. But it's really a dog. It's not a crocodile, it's really a dog. Okay? So anyway, Barack Obama is scared of the supermoon. Okay? And this supermoon, somehow or another, I have a connection with this moon. Okay? And people, do you know what's over my head right now? The Orion belt. Some of it. Because I don't want to move the camera because I have a good shot here, but and they're so high up I wouldn't get them good anyway. But anyway, right over my head, people, are the stars of heaven, okay? Actually, that's not Orion. Orion is gone already. I'm sorry, it's not Orion. Orion is way over where the sun is at. Way over to the west, but there's a whole thing of star above my head, people. Oh, okay, it's a Big Dipper. That's a Big Dipper. The Big Dipper directly above my head. Anyway, like I was saying, right? I have a connection with this moon, the sun, and the star, people. And in the Egyptian text, Ra, the eye of Ra. Okay, Ra. Okay, Orion, I think Orion was the Almighty, right? And Orion is also Hero. And the moon, in the sun, it is right eye, right? And Sirius is his left eye, and the moon is the third eye. Okay? The moon is supposed to be the third eye, but somehow the moon shifted position and blinded Sirius, blacked out Sirius, to become the left eye. And I think the devil did that. So I think really what happened, I think the moon is supposed to be the third eye, from where come wisdom. If it's not the moon, it's Sirius. One of them is the third eye. Either the moon, I could have it wrong, okay? But there's three of them. People look at that. Wow! Did y'all just see that? Oh, that was a plane, huh? You just went right across the moon? I just saw it. I think it was an airplane, though. Anyway. The Almighty have three eyes. The sun, the moon, and Sirius. Sirius, I think really Sirius is supposed to be the left eye and the moon is supposed to be the third eye. That's what I really believe. But the way the texts have it, the way they interpret it is that the moon is the left eye and the sun the right eye. But Sirius is in there somewhere. So Sirius is either the left eye or the middle eye, and the moon shifted position and became the left eye. And that's why this was evil. But who shifted the moon? Did the moon shift on its own, or did some evil power did it? I don't know. Hey, I'll call you when I get down, okay? I'm on my roof, I'll call you when I get down, okay? I'm on my roof, I'll call you when I get down in a few minutes. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. All right, bye. Anyway, sending out some spiritual vibe to the people. Okay, I'm about to blow some of this ganja smoke to the people. Send out some spiritual vibes, okay, my people? So, Mr. Barack Obama, why are you afraid of the moon? We're gonna find out. Why are you afraid of my moon? Okay? I know you, Mr. Obama, I know you. Okay, I know you from an ancient past. I know you. I just ain't put my finger on it yet, but I know you. And I think you are amen. You might look like, what your name? Akhenaten? I can't pronounce the names too much, but you look like him, but you are. Amen. Okay? You are Amen, Obama, and I'm gonna find out the truth. I'm gonna find out the truth, who you really are. So people, you see, I was right. A super full moon, okay? Are we gonna have an earthquake someplace in the world? I don't know. The time is 9:39 p.m. June 15th. My Lord, if there's gonna be an earthquake, right? I'm begging you, as always, be merciful to the innocent, okay? If you don't have to kill anybody, if no one have to die, don't let him die, my Lord, okay? So that we may not be found guilty of bloodshed. Let us not be like them, my Lord, okay? Let us not be like them. I care not for the guilty, you know that. Because the guilty had time to change and they haven't changed, so I care not for the guilty. But please have mercy on the innocent, my Lord. Please have mercy on the innocent. Let us not be like them, okay? Okay, one love. I'm going down off this roof now. So earth people, one love, okay? And feel the vibes of the moon, okay? Feel the vibes. I love ya. Bye-bye.